I'm at least set back reporting.
Just to see if he wanted to pop off like he was popping off when he was on stage.
What did he say?
Oh, he didn't say nothing.
Floyd, have you ever dealt with somebody with a personality like McGregor in all your boxing career? Do you remember anybody that's similar?
Not bad. You know, he stole my blueprint, ran with it, put aside. You know, it's nothing but, I like it.
Does it feel good to kind of not have to do carry on weight for you?
I've been doing the mean coats and the flashiness, and that was years ago. But be cool.
Does it feel good to not have to carry all that weight to promote a fight, and you got another guy on the other side that's doing a lot of this work?
I mean, we're doing crazy numbers. You know, forget what y'all hearing. We're doing crazy numbers, and we're not here to knock anyone else. You know, in the sport of boxing, I wish everybody nothing but the best. In MMA, I wish everybody nothing but the best. You know, I had a great career, so I can't sit right here and try to give knowledge and try to help warriors and fighters go to that next level and then sit right here and then knock them. I can't do that. You know, when I'm the face of contact sports.
And touch on that a little bit more. Floyd's responsibility is a lot more different than any other normal fighter because he's also the promoter. So he's having to kind of wear both hats and make decisions, and you know, so he just doesn't have to worry about just getting in shape. He has an incredible amount of responsibility overseeing everything the way that he wants things ran.
Floyd, Leonard weighed in earlier, but
got the AC on this motherfucker.
Cut the joint.
Leonard weighed in earlier on this, but with you being the promoter, are you disappointed at all that the fight's not a sellout yet?
Our fight is doing unbelievable numbers. When I say unbelievable, we're up high in the numbers. The pay-per-view numbers will be unbelievable, and we will have a sold-out crowd.
Yes.
I'm not worried about that.
And we're going to blow past our previous record, as I stated earlier.
And my previous record is?
72 million.
Yes.
Do you feel you're going to beat the Pacquiao pay-per-view numbers?
Hopefully. We're on the pace.
And again, I'll touch on it again. Right now, where we're at today, in some of the categories, we've already surpassed Maypac.
Can you give us an idea of the categories?
Sure, some of the foreign numbers. Best believe we're going to break those records. We're going to break pay-per-view records in the UK, Australia, and a few others.
Is Nate Diaz going to walk you
in? This fight will be shown to 150 countries, you know, alone. And again, we've opened this thing up right now where I'm encouraging the fans to go out and buy right now so you don't have to wait. You know, that's the key. Buy right now, you don't have to wait.
Because the day of, I got to charge a little bit more.
Floyd, when you say to Conor, you know, without Dana, this fight doesn't happen. You work for Dana and things like that. Do you get the sense that bothers him, that he's not his own boss?
That's not really what I said. You know, this guy wanna see me myself. This is genuine. This is real. This is raw. This is real. This is genuine. You know, if anybody know me, they know I'm genuine. They know I'm raw. They know I'm real. Any Lamborghini you see me in, you know I own it.
Absolutely.
Any mansion you see me in, you know it's paid for. And I wasn't, you know, on All Access, I wasn't, you know, I live next door to Maloof right here. And he has and you know, where we live, you gotta go through two gates, okay? So we live in top flight, you know, top shelf, creme de la creme. So what I'm meaning is this, you know, no rented cars for training camp, you know, got a drop head outside. That ain't my first one, won't be my last one. But the most important thing about my career and what I want to share, what I want to give knowledge to all these young fighters, what these young fighters and what they're doing, even like Conor McGregor, they get their money, they want to blow everything that night up. Or, you know, we have to think about 20 years from now and 30 years from now. I'm still living the same way because I made smart investments. You know, then a lot of times you hear certain things, you're going to continue to hear certain things. You cannot. Since they couldn't defeat me in the ring, they tried to defeat me mentally, so I can be defeated physically. But like I said before, I'm sharp. You know, I've been through a lot, not perfect. I strive to be a perfectionist, but like I said, like I always said, God only made one thing perfect, and that's my boxing record.
Have you followed the Paulie story at all the past week, and if so, what do you make of it?
I spoke on the Paulie thing earlier. You know, that's not my thing to get in the middle of their Conor McGregor and Paulie's back and forth bickering. Paulie's a friend of mine. I respect him as a fighter. He's one of the best commentators out there because he has knowledge of the game. A lot of times we have people that's commentating. We have commentators with fight shows who never fought a day in their life. I think it's better if you get some type of training in boxing, you know, so you can really know about the sport of boxing. Not saying that you may not know a little bit about the sport, but that's like a trainer working in my corner, and I need Roger in my corner, my dad in my corner. I need somebody that had experience of being in that square circle before. How are you gonna be in my corner if I'm in a crunch situation? You can't help me or give me the knowledge because you've never been in a crunch situation yourself. But if you have experience with being in there, you can kind of give me information on what I have to do when I'm in a tight situation.
Floyd, you said this is your last fight. Have you taken a moment to sort of appreciate all the, you know?
No, I'm okay. Yeah. I did it for over 30 years. I'm okay.
Good?
I did it for over 30 years. So.
Stillundefeated.com.
Calm down. Let the people do their job.
If you would have started training MMA early in your career, you think you would have been successful at it?
I'm glad I chose what I chose, because if I didn't choose what I choose, now with this fight, the fourth biggest fight in history, is all four is Floyd Mayweather. We're talking about the biggest fights in history. I'm not here to knock any other fighter, because I take my hat off and I commend the legendary champions that paved the way for me to be where I'm at today.
Floyd, you were on the world tour with Conor. You were inches from him, and you do your due diligence on your opponents. Within being inches of him, were you able to pull something from that experience to use in the ring?
He's confident. They're always confident. They're always confident, but it's a little different when you get in there with Floyd Mayweather. Because when the bell rang and you're across from me, and you look around, damn, it's really here. And me, it's another day. So I approach everything, it's just another day. My mentality from the beginning, why I'm undefeated, because my mentality is the same thing always. Fuck it, it's gonna be what it's gonna be.
Floyd, Conor had Paulie, obviously everyone knows that, in his training camp. Mm-hmm. There's talks of you having Errol Spence in yours. Is that something, clarify, did you bring someone in? Did you just use your camp? Who are some of your sparring partners? How do you get ready for a guy like Conor?
Errol Spence helped me get ready for the Robert Guerrero fight. And I needed a guy like Errol Spence to push me. Hell of a fighter. I needed him to push me because remember, when I fought Guerrero, I just came home from jail. So my body was totally different, you know, from doing 1,200 push-ups a day. So my upper body was a lot bigger. You know, I had to balance the weight out, you know, from top to bottom. I had to make sure my body was evenly proportioned. But Errol Spence, like I said, I told you guys about Errol Spence a long time ago. I told you guys he's a hell of a fighter, and that guy gave me some good work, and I needed that. We need guys like this in the sport of boxing.
Floyd, you worked to put together the undercard as well. What can people look to expect?
I'm gonna let Leonard come and touch on that undercard.
Again, you know, the Mayweather, our undercard is stacked with Mayweather Promotions fighters. You know, obviously, Badu Jack, Javante Davis, and Andrew Tabidi. It's going to be a very exciting undercard.
You know, but we have a pre-card also.
Yeah, the Fox, I talked about that earlier.
Oh.
The Fox prelims, obviously we have Thomas DeLorme, he's fighting Sean Porter, and then we have Juan Araldes, and it's very exciting about. And then we have Savannah Marshall, our young protege, she's from the UK. She's gonna make her pro debut. We're very excited. We have a tremendous undercard, and the fans are gonna get their money.
Floyd,
gonna get their money.
Floyd, one of the things you told Conor in the press tour that he taps out, and it rattled him a little bit. Will you have Nate Diaz walk you out?
I'm just focused on the fight. You know, but we can't say who's going to walk Mayweather out. But, you know, I'm just really focused on the fight right now.
Floyd, once you leave, the biggest pay-per-view star in boxing will be gone. Is there a boxer out there that you see that in the near future might even be able to do a million buys?
That's hard.
I know.
I'm going to be honest with you guys. I don't want to, because I'm not going to toot my own horn, but it's hard. The reason why it's going to be so difficult is you have to have a fighter with a certain charisma, a certain swag, a certain aura. You got to have a fighter with either they love you or they hate you, or it's a little bit of both. It takes a lot. And Ali had it. Certain fighters got it. I mean, with Mayweather, it's no gamble. It's for sure money. And other fighters, it's a gamble.
And let me just touch on that again. I mean, he don't give himself enough credit, but he's been willing to work. A lot of these fighters have these expectations where they just think shit just falls out the sky. And Floyd's the type of fighter. He didn't mind all the things that me and Kelly would do for promotion.
Like Dancing with the Stars. I didn't mind going to Dancing with the Stars. You know, I seen a bigger plan. I didn't mind going on WWE. Everything was the game plan. Even like when I went away from the sport and I told you guys it was a retirement. It wasn't a retirement. That was a game plan that we had. You know, we left, we had the hair, then we come back, we bought hair with the gold tee. We left Pretty Boy before we come back, Floyd Money Mayweather. So it's a game plan. You always gotta have a game plan. You know, even like this fight, you know, I'm the brilliant one because I'm the one that made this fight happen.
Is there a plan after this fight, Floyd?
Oh, no, I ain't a plan. You know, to continue to...
You just told us you had a plan, so...
Well, I look forward to the young fighters to the next level, but just continue to do what I'm doing, you know, do what I do, because there's a lot of people that's involved in my career, even like Boza Edwards. You know, I've been knowing former world champion Cornelius Boza Edwards for 21 years. You know, I've been knowing him from the first day I walked into top rank promotions. I went to the, and I met him. But every day, you know, we got Bob Ware, you know, AKA Do It All Bob, as we call him. Him and Boza, you know, they open up this gym every day for fighters and fans all around the world. They put up the boxing ring. You know, sometimes I'm not even here. And I only have a key to the gym, but I travel all around the world. I'll be everywhere. They make sure that the fighters are able to train and work hard so they can accomplish what they want to accomplish in life. So, you know, those people don't really get the credit that they're due. And they work every day. Even my Uncle John, my Uncle Gerald, my cousin Steven, and even my cousin DeJuan, they come here and open up this gym every day for these fighters, and also open up the gym for the fans so the fans can come into the fight world.
Good, guys?
Yeah.
Thank you.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.